a storied history. At one point, it was sort of a cool punctuation mark. And now, if you use it gratuitously, you sound like the sort of elderly person who puts cyber in front of things to make them sound hip. I enjoy this mark. You know, we call it the at sign, which is not indicated phonetically by the mark itself. In a variety of other cultures, the at sign has some more interesting names. In Italian, it is a snake. In Dutch or German, a monkey tail. In Chinese, a little mouse. In Russian, a dog. That's kind of weird. In Hebrew, this is my favorite one, a strudel.